The truth is that every human being has the infinite potential to heal himself. The doctors must complete the medical science. Complete means we should not only treat the symptoms, but we cure the disease.
Every individual has his own innate strength. He has his own inherent and innate healing abilities that are lying dormant in him. What as specialists, what accomplished specialists we do is only 50% to the patients. So the 50% of the recovery process has to happen from within the patient, which means he has his own innate abilities that are lying dormant, and we need to energize this strength or this power or this healing abilities to enhance their recovery process.
I'm here. Like, what you can do is you can culture the cancer cell or AIDS cells or whatever is there and bring it to me. I will project those cosmic waves on the cells. And after a few days, please study whether the cancerous cells, the number is the same or it has reduced, or whether the number of healthy cells has increased or not. I can show it to you. I can demonstrate to you. Now, this is on the cell culture, whereas a human being, if you will do on human being, the results will be much faster.
Because in layman term, miracle is defined something which is beyond the capacity of this brain to understand. But in fact, these are the basic laws of nature.
It is possible in the method that is being deployed in the Shiv Yoga meditations, that it has a rapid, quick and measurable results in a short period of time. And I think as scientific and medical professionals, if there is a directional evidence, then that is a very strong piece of indication that there is a process at work, and therefore it needs to be pursued seriously by all those who embrace it and by all those who get to know about it.
All these principles of the Shiv Yoga will be there in the books, and they will be in the medical books also, because it is only on the receptivity of the medical community to accept the things. And the way people are seeing changes and these so-called miracles which a layman utters, because the moment you enter this Shiv Yoga, these miracles are everyday occurrences.
He was brought to the hospital by his wife, and he has no pulse, no breathing. I happened to be at that time in the emergency room. So humko baba ji ko yaad kiya, we gave him a healing, talk to his wife, tell her to do the little meditation. We did everything is possible in USA. Still survival rate is less than 2% for out of hospital cardiac arrest, which are more than 10 minutes away. Believe it or not, 2 days may that guy woke up. He is one of the big CEO of the Fortune 500 company. He's alive and he's thankful. That are all miracles, which are, I think that's what we call science beyond science.
Shiva Yoga is not everything about healing. Shiva Yoga is a way of life. Healing just comes by the way. And healing in the hands of healers can become very powerful when it is under the able guidance of a guru.
और मैं एक चीज जानता हूं कि यदि आप चाहोगे तो मिरेकल होगा. वो मैं नहीं करूंगा, आप ही करोगे. मैं रास्ता दिखाता जाऊंगा. इफ ए पर्सन हैज द कैपेसिटी टू प्रोड्यूस ए डिजीज, बिकॉज इट इज द पेशेंट हु हैज क्रिएटेड ए डिजीज, डज नॉट ही हैव द कैपेसिटी टू रिवर्ट द होल प्रोसेस? एंड दैट इज वॉट वी आर ट्राइंग टू टीच इन शिव योग, that you followed certain patterns, and these patterns, in detail I am explaining, these patterns are root cause of this disease. We have to reverse the process. When they do Shivayog Sadhana, so much of peace and tranquility they start generating, so much of healing energy. Now, what is healing? It's not a magic that I'm doing a magic shoo and you are healed. Basically, every one of you is emitting vibrations. Now, anybody comes in that aura, then it is going to change his vibrations.
These subtle, powerful energies that are unseen by the human eyes were bringing profound changes in the lives of lakhs of people who practiced Shiva Yoga.
If you are a little sensitive individual, you can feel energy flowing into your body. There are vibrations of that magnitude that your hands feel the vibration, the body feels the vibration, the site at which they are directed and intended. You can feel that somebody is caressing it, somebody is touching it, and somebody is doing something on the top. On several occasions, I felt somebody touch my liver and healed. Right? And it's not that I am a doctor and I know where the liver is, but I know where the movement is going on.
And the basic principle of Shiv Yoga healing is, when you send energy at that level of consciousness, or that hollow space, or that space between the neutrons and electrons, you transform that negative energy into positive energy, and when that positive energy is the raw material of the new cell, the healthy cell is formed, and it takes only a fraction of a second to get the things done.
Babaji took a step forward to authenticate the powers of Shiva Yoga healing by being subject to the experiments subjected by doctors and medical professionals on how healing can take place. In the United States, in front of many doctors, Babaji demonstrated how tumors, cysts, and kidney stones could be shrunk in minutes with Shiva Yoga healing.
It is very, very miraculous, I can see. कि जो हम कितने ऑपरेट करके तब स्टोन निकालेंगे वो बाबा जी ने वहीं के वहीं श्रिंक करते चले जा रहे हैं और वो स्पेस भी भर गया विद नेचुरल सेल्स विच हेल्दी सेल्स.
Now, if in a live meditation session, a polyp or a tumor is going into remission, the ultrasonologist can measure it. You can see it happening, but why it is happening, he can't. In radiology, we don't teach that. Okay, we may teach that in chemotherapy or radiotherapy, or that it may respond to a certain medicine.
I went to US, and this was a Shiva Yoga Shivir. And they said, we want to conduct trial. I said, no, already the Shivir is on. What I will like to demonstrate to you is that you bring a patient and bring the ultrasound machine. And then and there, I would like to show how, when you become a medicine, how you will work. So there was a patient of tumor, cyst, and stones. And in front of doctors, and this was a mixed group, 80 doctors were there, and total group was of 1,000 sadhaks. And the camera was fixed with the ultrasound machine, and on the screen it was visible. That was the first time I also saw how the photo comes in the ultrasound. And the ultrasonographer doctor, he was demonstrating.
I'll prefer that we should have lesser electronics around, as less as we can. In the meantime, can I communicate to the lady who is can she listen to me? And gradually you will reach to that incident which is very significant to this situation which you are in now, and you are likely to relive and re-experience it. It may be this life incident or the incident of the mother's womb or of past life, whatever is there. But you keep breathing, deep breath in and deep breath out, deep breath in and deep breath out. And I said, okay, now I'll project the cosmic energy and see. And in front of everybody, on the screen, the tumor started shrinking. And communicate to her brain and heal. Heal the impressions, heal the cells. Keep sending this message to that incident, which is the root of this. What is the reading?
This is the site where she had a tumor operated upon, we call craniotomy scar. And if you remember the old image, around this area, that's where the what we call the tumor mass was there. It's not there. Really, it was a very big mass, what we call. And as every image is Dr. Saab were taking it, the mass was shrinking. And by the time his blessing were given completely, and I don't see the mass.
Just give it to her how she's feeling.
I want to thank you, Babaji, and I want to thank every single person in this room for praying and chanting.
Thank to the Lord.
And to obviously to the Lord. I know that I was, I don't normally shake like that, but I do shake. I shook very, very, very much. I was almost levitating. So thank you to Lord. Thank you to you, Babaji, for giving me this.
Next one, this young man, he is diagnosed with what we call gallbladder polyp.
That's the polyp. And that size is 0.83 centimeter. The other small polyp is here, which is 3.38 centimeter. So he has two polyps. I had frozen once image here, which is 0.43. And within a matter of like 5 or 10 minutes, when Babaji asked me what's happening, I thought, let me just get another image, which I did in a real time. And it's 0.32.
We started with 0.8, then as we healing started, it was 0.43, and then it became to 0.32.
Throughout the entire experience, I just could feel shaking through my legs and my arms, and it was just kind of amazing.
This lady has a gallbladder, which was discovered asymptomatic gallstones.
The healing will start now, and I'll just continue to scan.
Seems that it's probably is vanishing now. It's gone. It's gone. Hold on, I can't find it.
There are no words for any one of us.
Babaji, you're gonna put us out of business. I'm sorry to say.
No. Yeah. Our doctors are going to combine. See, without ultrasound, I would have been nothing. It's a combination, the ancient wisdom and modern science. So this is you have to give the medication and the curriculum which we are going to work. Believe me, the vision is, my imagination, the vision is that you are going to cure and teach the world. It's our doctors are going to give a gift to the world.
Gee, thank you. I don't know how to thank you.
Bless you. And then I'm not aware, the doctors, they said, we are surprised not because the tumor is shrinking, but we are surprised the gap which was happening in between in the kidneys, even those healthy cells, they were regenerating that fast as the diseased tumor cells was reducing.
The holy masters already know the unknown realms that science researches today. The ancient yogis of the East were masters of the secret mysteries of human potentials. Masters in the subtle realms unseen to the naked eye, and masters in the mysteries beyond life and death. they always had solutions to every problem of life on earth and were powerful beyond their physical presences.
But then doctor is also human, and the patient is also human, and collectively we are trying to understand the mysteries of our human body. Shiv Yoga is our ancient culture. It is our inheritance which Babaji has given us with such intense love and affection.
From the same lineage of the powerful ancient rishis, there is a master who has been carrying the secrets of these mysteries to the common man for the well-being of the mankind and nature.
He's a very fascinating human being, very different from you and me in many ways. A sign of an evolved human being is that he or she makes you feel exactly the same way. But there is a body of knowledge that he or she has that in that domain is superior to yours.
Babaji is a vortex of spiritual energy. So he's an embodiment of a lot of spiritual force. And who has clearly, I think he has an absolute clarity on what influences our life.
But then he is willing, he clearly says he is not a doctor. He says, this is working, but please help me understand how it is working. Okay? Now, so then medical professionals come in, that this is how the biochemistry process might be working.
I am a yogi, and whatever I am speaking is what I experience through my meditation. And share the ancient wisdom with you.
The fact that he is very respectful and open to medical professionals, doctors and scientists to work with him, I think is a very positive sign.
Hardly 12 beats I believe. I'm here, I'm looking from this above. I wonder what's happening? Physical was not present. I've moved out of my body.
The whole wisdom was there with our rishis, the yogis. But now the whole wisdom was passed on from one master to another disciple then. And it was all hidden. I want to share it with the world because world needs it.
India's spiritual heritage actually has the potential of impacting our DNA. At the DNA level itself, changes can come in.
A yogi from the lineage of ancient Indian rishis, Avadhoot Baba Sivanandji, for the past 15 years has been sharing these powerful healing modalities of the highest dimensions and teaching the science of how these dimensions can be tapped into by humans and raise the vibrational frequencies of a diseased part, spontaneously bringing healing.
People thought I'm talking, but actually I was working on those scars in the illumination. And the moment those were erased, the person who was talking, 10-year-old disease, he said, "Oh, I'm all right." You have to take that person to that memory, and as he is going, you are going with him and sending that light and erasing those scars. And the moment the scar is erased, the movie is erased, only the light will come and the person feels all right. That is the scientific phenomena.
If there are 10 patients, we give the same treatment to the 10 patients, not every patient will get better. The treatment is the same. Patient, the type of patient cohort that we are dealing with, the type of problems they have may be similar in the 10 patients, but only 5 may get better. But the 5 other patients may deteriorate and die. Why does that happen? So that is something that science has failed to understand.
We don't know everything. Okay, so there is more to be known. And if it is presented scientifically, if it is explained in the language that the modern scientists understand, then it can get very quick acceptance.
We have really struggled to still understand how the healing processes works to a large extent, and what makes someone recover very well, and what really, with all, whatever best efforts you put in, you know, we fail in certain cases. There is a cosmic energy, and there is a different vibration levels that we need to work on to definitely get patients better. It is truly a science beyond science, and I don't think science will ever conquer and have answers for every aspect of healthcare that we deal with.
Medicine works at the chemical level, at the cellular level, but the Shiv Yoga healing energy works at the nuclear level, and that changed total configuration. Even the root cause of the disease is changed with the Shiv Yoga healing, and that definitely I am experiencing in some of my patients.
Spirituality ke aspect mein humne bahut sari cheez suni hai, ye books, wo books, ye seminar. Jab Baba ji ka lecture maine pehli baar, even before I went to the seminar, jab maine padha aur jab maine suna, to itna simplify unhone, jise hamari language mein kehte user friendly kar diya.
Science is thinking, it's logic, it's reasoning. And this is where a thinking beyond what anyone has ever thought of. We have got cellular biologists, we've got molecular biology, we've got so many details of biology also about the cell structure. But that has only gone into the physical structure of the cell or the chemical and electrical functioning of the cell. But Babaji has thought way beyond it. His thinking, his science of thinking has gone beyond the level of the cell as we know it. So therefore, it's a sports science beyond science. Because he has been thinking of a behavior or reasoning or logic of a cell beyond our knowledge of the cell. We have got electron microscopes. He's gone beyond that.
The medicines which we give to the patients, they act on patient on molecular level. But Shiv Yoga healing, it acts on sub-molecular, sub-atomic particles also. I can say that science has not reached up to the depth where Shiv Yoga healing can reach.
Till now, the science says what is the pathology, what is the etiology of the disease. Now, if you don't find any etiology, you will say it is, we don't have any etiology of it, but definitely there is something there. And science, beyond science, is that if a thing is happening, means it should have a logic reason behind it. We don't know the reason, that is different part. We should find the reason, and the reason is the signal. Many times in many of our programs, Babaji has made it very clear why the signals, where the signals affect, which part of the DNA, which part of the DNA is stimulated to produce a particular type of RNA.
Every doctor who is seeing the patient, the patient certainly has lesser energy, lesser life force energy, and the moment he comes in front of doctor, we clairvoyantly we see it, and if the PIP photography is available, I will show it to you. He immediately creates a connection with the doctor. And the law of physics says that the energy from the higher level, it starts flowing towards the lower level. So we will have to find a way where we can enhance his energy level.
The glaucoma in ophthalmology is an incurable disease. And after giving them such a meditation, I have noticed, no, it's not a scientifically proved thing, their deterioration of visual acuity, field defect has reduced.
We have been noticing some very interesting phenomenon in all these investigations, which is not normally seen in a short period of time. And we've noticed in the most recent program and in some of the earlier programs that in the course of just 4 days, there have been significant changes in parameters such as the thyroid stimulated hormone and many others. If one really wants to get better and practices meditation, the Shiv Yoga methods earnestly, honestly, we could see some phenomenal continued improvements going forward.
this has been studied, but not so extensively. But these findings have been described, though practically we had not experienced this.
And with one difference which is important, that over a period of time, yes, if you practice meditation for 6 months, 1 year, the results are measurable. It's not normal to see measurable results in 4 days.
Right? 3 days, 4 days.
And the trends were the same.
Trends were the same across parameters. Trends were the same across parameters.
If the doctors cannot do something beyond that, if you have a full stop with the doctors, Shivyoga has lot many potential to do whatever you want, you can do it.
तो साइंस बियॉन्ड साइंस का सबसे बड़ा फायदा ये हुआ कि हम मरीज में और अपने डॉक्टरों में ये भाव पैदा करने में सफल रहे हैं कि जो हमारी होलिस्टिक अप्रोच है, जो हम सोचते हैं कि इसके बाद भी कुछ है, जहां आप जीवन का अंत समझते थे, वहां ऐसा कुछ नहीं है, कोई अंत प्रारंभ नहीं है.
बिकॉज वी आर द बीइंग ऑफ कॉन्शियसनेस, देयर इज आउटर कॉन्शियसनेस, देयर इज इनर कॉन्शियसनेस. And inner consciousness is very powerful. And it was her inner consciousness that time was working. And the patient became all right. So these are the things if we learn. And I have seen the doctors, they are becoming best healers. They are, you do the diagnosis through the diagnostic equipments. But the doctors I have seen, they become wonderful clairvoyants. So much so that the person standing there and say, I have discomfort. He said, you have a gap in the 10th or 12th vertebra. There is something. And the patient said, how can you say that? He said, you go and get it checked. And the person said, no, I'm coming with the reports. And exactly that vertebra's, the gap was there.
Looking at the relapse of symptoms and helplessness of doctors treating patients beyond a certain level, Babaji, as a compassionate sage, sprung into action to do his bit in helping medical science towards complete healing. He began teaching doctors themselves this sacred science with profound positive results.
If we can make doctor as a medicine, I can assure you, we can cure every disease. And if doctor enhances his life force energy, and if he learns to project that life force energy, then that therapy will be laser beam therapy. Treating a patient, no, I will not say, and you will not even like it, that the patient come and you say, okay, you have come to OPD, or close your eyes and I close my eyes. They will not like that doctor. So it has to be while you are giving a treatment, one aspect is the physical way you are giving treatment, and there is another way which is not visible, that is through energy.
Two lectures I attended, and the first lecture itself, Babaji was able to connect himself with the audience. I found that many people have been cured by the healing power of Babaji, and they were grateful to Babaji on that day. Second day I could see that Babaji was sending his positive energy to people, and I could see the metamorphosis going on in the auditorium. It was a thing which you have to see to believe. If somebody else tells you, you may not believe. You have to be there to believe. And I saw that with my own eyes.
Now, if the doctor become the medicine and start producing those cosmic waves and project at the blockages which are disturbing, this is what I can show it to you. Anybody working in public dealings, let it be a lawyer or a judge or anyone else, where the people, those who are suffering, they come to him
they always carry those leave those psychic impressions and the negative etheric debris and all that. So morning and evening, if they have practiced this sadhana of erasing and expansion of consciousness, it has been observed, like my experience is, that the doctors, those who were specialists in certain field, they also suffer from the same disease. Apart from disinfecting physically, we must know the way where in the morning and in the evening I disinfect myself internally. I clean my aura. I erase those psychic impressions. I erase those neuropathways which I have created. And apart from that, I expand my level of life force energy. And that life force energy, when I go to see the patient, I am happy. I am not worried whether I'll be depleted or not.
When I begin my day, the first thing I do is clean the etheric debris. Clean the etheric debris. And I get connected with the universe in a most positive mode in the morning. And I stay like that in the next 24 hours. My connection with my patients is directed to change their intracellular memory. This is what Babaji has been telling us about that space and the psychic impressions which our patients carry with them in that space.
Now, in the operation theater, after the operation, you disinfect the operation theater. But the patients, those who come for the surgery, they are so much in pain. And definitely the black clouds, if you see clairvoyantly, the black clouds. And when you cut the skin, the damage in the cells also produce the gray energy. And that remains there. And if you know the process of cleaning the etheric debris, you will find the success rate in that operation theater. You do it for yourself. And you'll find the success rate will increase.
इसी तरह से मैंने ओटी में बहुत जबरदस्त इफेक्ट देखा.
The science of CVO healing which Babaji has taught us, and fracture, both of those fractures united, which otherwise would have undergone a major surgical procedure.
ये और भी डॉक्टर्स होते हैं साथ में कली कि वो कर देंगे आपका ट्रीटमेंट वो. तो पेशेंट ये बोलता नहीं आपसे ही कराना, आप ही कर दो. तो आई यूज्ड टू से कि इस चीज में मेरा हाथ उतना अच्छा नहीं है. तो वो पेशेंट बोलता है आप कैसा भी कर दो बट आप ही कर दो. बट पेशेंट्स का इतना ट्रस्ट बन जाता है आपके ऊपर या उनको इतना अच्छा फील होने लगता है आपके साथ कि आप कुछ भी आप ही कर दो, जैसा भी करोगे आप ही कर दो.
शिव योग इनवाइट्स डॉक्टर्स टू कम एंड लर्न द सीक्रेट साइंसेस एंड एम्पावर देमसेल्व्स इन द फील्ड ऑफ मेडिसिन to bring faster healing and recovery in patients. In this special Shiv Yoga Science Beyond Science workshop, doctors not only learn these powerful sciences, but are also empowered with the powerful tool of the ancient Himalayan masters of the East.
Ancient Indian philosophers, doctors, they were practicing this since thousands of years before. So I think in the modern medicine also, we should combine these two things. And that will help a lot to the medical profession.
That I have kept reserved only for the doctor. I will love to. Because I want that the ancient wisdom of East, if we combine with the knowledge of West, the medical knowledge of the West, we can complete the medical science.
Medical science should be combined with Shiv Yoga healing science. And definitely the outcome of treatment will be much better.
Yes, to large extent. and the amount of medicine required can be curtailed down because of the Shiva yoga.
With the cosmic power of Shiva yoga, you can enhance the efficacy of those allopathic drugs. And not only that, you can reduce considerably the side effects.
जैसे हमने देखा है, जब रिपोर्ट्स करते हैं साधना के पहले, छः छः दिन की साधना होती है, उसके पहले के ब्लड रिपोर्ट्स, उसके बाद के ब्लड रिपोर्ट्स में फ़र्क देखा गया है। आज की दुनिया एविडेंस मांगती है, नहीं हमको तो चमत्कार देखना है, तो चमत्कार देखो। बाबा जी के सेमिनार्स में डॉक्टर के पुरुवन एम्स का एक सेमिनार था जिसके बारे में मैंने पढ़ा था, जो मैं वहाँ था अहमदाबाद में, तब वहाँ के डॉक्टर्स ने प्रूफ दिया है कि ये ब्लड शुगर देखो, ये देखो, ये कोलेस्ट्रॉल देखो, ये देखो। आई थिंक एवरीथिंग कैन बी क्योर्ड, एवरीथिंग कैन बी क्योर्ड।
मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम अ डिजीज इज कॉज्ड बाय सम साइकोसोमेटिक फैक्टर। बाय डूइंग शिव योग हीलिंग वी रिमूव दीज फैक्टर्स एंड एज सून एज द फैक्टर इज रिमूव्ड एंड देन वी डू द सिम्टोमेटिक ट्रीटमेंट, वी गेट द ट्रेमेंडस रिजल्ट्स।
योर एबिलिटी टू लव एवरीवन, केयर फॉर एवरीवन, and have empathy for everyone, compassion for everyone. I think this is something which medical science, I have to honestly say, is not inculcating, because these feelings you can't teach. This has to come from within a doctor. I think that is something which automatically comes in by doing Shiva Yoga.
When I'm operating on topical or when I'm operating under local anesthesia, the patients are at times very apprehensive. I used to give them sedatives. But you know, sedatives are such medicine where certain patient, they get, you know, they start talking irrelevant, they start behaving irrelevantly because of the effect of those sedatives. But when I told them, when I give them this therapy, Shiva Yoga, they are quiet, composed, and many times I need not have to give them these sedatives and tranquilizer medicines. So in this way they help me quite a lot in my operative cases.
The doctor hain jo apni clinic mein baith ke aaj patient dekh rahe hain, aur baba ki itni kripa hai unke upar ki jab se baba se jude hain unke number of patients duguna nahi 10 guna badhe hain. Wo itni aur itne busy doctor hote hue bhi wo to raat mein sadhana kar hi rahe hain jab marijon se fursat milti hai, to unka jo clinic hai itna positive ho gaya hai कि जब पेशेंट उसमें इंटर करता है उसी समय वो फील करता है कि रिलैक्स महसूस करता है।
साधना करने के बाद वहीं से अपनी क्लिनिक को और अपने डे केयर सेंटर को हीलिंग देता हूँ।
वी डॉक्टर्स हैव डन इट एंड वी हैव सीन कि बीमारी आते आते, कई बार मेरी उम्र भी हो रही है 54, कभी लगता है कि हाँ हो सकता है कि जॉइंट में कहीं लगता है कमजोरी, पता लगा साधना में बैठे जाके बिल्कुल हट गया, थकान एकदम थके चूर हो रहे हैं, साधना में बैठे बिल्कुल फ्रेश हो गए। कैसे हो जाता है ये? क्योंकि वो अंदर ही अंदर हमारे ये जो सेल्युलर लेवल पे वर्क कर रही है हमारी साधना, शिव योग साधना, दैट हैज इंक्रीज्ड आवर स्ट्रेंथ ट्रेमेंडसली।
होलिस्टिक टोटल क्वालिटी मैनेजमेंट ऑफ आवर लाइव्स इज एसेंशियल। Doctors are very favorite for our guru. He loves them because he thinks and he knows that doctors are very good healers.
Shiva Yoga has given definition to my life. It has made me identify what my life is for. It slowed me down into a pace in which I can enjoy everything around me.
So at the end of the day, we'll be only getting our patients better, and we'll be doing service to our patients. And I think the joy is in serving the poor, as we understand, serving the poor, serving the needy, serving the suffering. As Babaji says, the whole joy is in giving the best care to the suffering patients. I practice Shiva Yoga, I can say with conviction that it definitely happens.
Each and every doctor should join Shiva Yoga. In my opinion, each and every doctor. Or Shiva Yoga should involve each and every doctor. And future of medicine with the Shiva Yoga healing is definitely very powerful. The total picture of medicine will change if each and every doctor will join Shiva Yoga. Or even I will suggest, if in medical college, this type of one course of this type of healing should and must be started. Then whole of the medical faculty
will be benefited.
As soon as the patient enters in my clinic, the patient gets relieved. He says that there is not a, we don't feel that we have come in an hospital. They feel very, very pleasing atmosphere. They are so confident when they come here. All the fear, all the anxiety, it goes. And they feel very confident and they are very happy treating by get treatment by me.
More and more medical personals, whether of any of the pathy, Unani, homeopathy, allopathy, any pathy, they should definitely learn this part of the study and our knowledge and our system so that they can help their patients better.
And believe me, I am not taking any medicine for to reduce the pain, but there is no pain.
And you are seeing those physical changes, those physical realities are changing because of that collective consciousness. And the day these things are practiced, again we will have those good olden days which we remember and which our rishis used to see and practice.
And our goal is to reconnect and re-resonate a man with the divine frequency, what we call Shiva Yoga. Yoga means resonance, Shiva means infinite. My resonance with the infinite divine light will automatically make me into a meta human being, a divine human being.
Babaji, I'd just like to make a comment. Well, the fault is in our training in this narrow field of allopathic medicine, and the time has come for a paradigm shift in our thinking. In general, we are not exposed to alternative therapies as allopathic doctors, and we also refuse to accept these therapies. The time has come to remove these blinkers. In my mind, the spiritual dimension has always been the backbone of healing, but we are not aware of it, and some of us do not even recognize it. As medical people, we see miracles all around us every day. I remember the first time I saw the birth of a baby. We also see growth and senescence. I'm amazed by this miracle of life. Thank you for introducing us to the spiritual dimension. And I speak on behalf of everyone here. The dawn of a new era has begun. Thank you.